Hello and welcome to Waterman Wellness, your pathway to health and wellness with local experts as your guides. I'm Michelle Wargo. We are in the dog days of summer here in Florida, and we're dedicating this episode to helping you stay active, healthy, and hydrated. A local orthopedist will explain how you can stay active when joint pain is slowing you down. We'll show you why you might also reach for a fork to quench your thirst. And we'll learn how Lake County EMS and Florida Hospital Waterman will help prepare you in the event of an emergency. But first, we have exciting news about new medical technology to help potentially dangerous heart conditions that is now available in Lake County, only from Florida Hospital Waterman. Arrhythmias, or irregular heartbeats, affect 4 million Americans. Some people are born with the abnormal heartbeats, while others, who have heart disease, hypertension, or other cardiac issues, can develop arrhythmias. Depending on the type of arrhythmia, a patient may experience pain, a rapid heartbeat, or blackouts, or even sudden cardiac arrest. In certain cases, doctors may decide to implant a defibrillator, which automatically applies an electrical shock to a heart that stops beating. Traditionally, those devices were implanted in the chest with a wire or lead going through the heart's veins. That causes discomfort for some active patients and can also increase risk for infection in the venous system. Florida Hospital Waterman is the first in Lake County to offer a new subcutaneous implantable defibrillator, or SICD, which doctors say has significant advantages.
The benefit is that this system now is this subcutaneous ICD system. It's implanted under the skin, but instead of going in the chest area so you don't see it, it actually goes right here under the armpit. So it stays right here parallel to the sternum. And what it does is when this device, kind of by the antenna function, will detect the heart rhythm of the heart, it delivered the energy, like an external paddle, will shock the heart. This is all under the skin. There's nothing deeper inside the body.
A risk of sudden death due to his cardiac disease led George Sanderson of Tavares to become Dr. Bryce's first patient to have the procedure.
Well, since I've had the device implanted, it's been like a huge weight has been lifted off my shoulders. I kind of don't worry about whether my heart's going to stop anymore, and I figure that if it does, you know, that this will take care of it. But not only has that weight been lifted off my mind, I think that my quality of life has improved.
Dr. Bryce says the new subcutaneous ICD is proven to provide the same reliable protection as a traditional ICD, but with a decreased chance of complications and potential damage to the heart and its surrounding areas. Dr. Bryce is excited about another new advancement in electrophysiology that is now available at Florida Hospital Waterman. This cardiac monitor, which is about a third of the size of a AAA battery, is the smallest implantable cardiac monitor device available.
They don't do therapy, but they make diagnosis of cardiac arrhythmias, most commonly slow heartbeats or extremely rapid heartbeats or irregular heartbeats that has link with risk of a stroke. Some people pass out once a year, once every 2 years, once every 6 months, and you never know what is gonna trigger to happen. So then it can help and identify an arrhythmia that is probably explaining that, and then you can treat accordingly.
The new cardiac monitoring device records every beat of the heart and allows the doctor to wirelessly monitor any occurrence of symptoms that may suggest a cardiac arrhythmia. Dr. Bryce explained that inserting both the new cardiac monitor and the subcutaneous ICD are minimally invasive procedures, and that often patients can go home and resume normal activity soon after they are implanted. Did you know that 85% of heart damage occurs within the first 2 hours of a heart attack? Recognizing the early warning signs and acting quickly to get help can save your life. Our next story is about a service available in our Lake County community designed to save precious minutes in a medical emergency.
What is the address of your emergency?
You may one day experience early heart attack symptoms, which include nausea, pain that travels down one or both arms, fatigue, chest pressure, and shortness of breath. Should you experience these symptoms, doctors say your best chance of survival is to call 911 instead of trying to get to the hospital on your own.
So we can get your medications, we can find out who your doctors are, we can find out if you have a cardiac history, who your cardiologist is, we can take a picture of your heart. The reason that's important is because if we can diagnose it and find it in the field, we can send it on to the emergency department, to those physicians and those doctors, so that they can see what we're seeing and then they can notify the cardiac team.
Now residents can participate in a program called Smart 911, which is free and only requires a little bit of your time on a computer, smartphone, or tablet device.
Smart 911 allows the actual citizen to provide information that they may not think about during an actual emergency, so it augments the information that they'll ask you for during an emergency. Medications would be a perfect one. Some of the medications during an emergency, you're stressed at that point of emergency, and if you're on multiple medications, the only way that you would know how to relay that information is to run to the medicine cabinet and grab them and try to read off labels during the emergency. If you had them in the system, that would be an updated list that could be readily available to the 911 dispatcher.
If someone has registered their residence on the Smart 911 system, we have a screen that'll automatically pop up as soon as we answer the phone. It will give us the name of the person that has registered and any other profiles that they have created within that one for any other family members in that residence. It can provide a description of how the home is laid out. We know exactly where to go. And it can also provide us with a history of the patient for information that could help our crews, again, be well prepared when they get to the residence.
The information you can put into the system can be as specific as whether you have pets in the home or even any special rooms where a loved one might stay. All important for emergency personnel in the event of a fire, medical, or other emergency. Simply go to smart911.com to create your profile. Adult children who live out of the area might want to help elderly parents register. And it's important to know the system will automatically contact you every 6 months to encourage you to update the information on your profile in case anything has changed. Now to a relatively new technology that is receiving mixed reviews. Electronic cigarettes, or e-cigarettes, have been touted as safer than regular tobacco cigarettes and an effective way to stop smoking. E-cigarettes are battery-operated devices that emit flavored vaporized solutions that provides a similar sensation to smoking tobacco. The vaping solution can have varying nicotine levels. Nicotine, of course, is the primary addictive ingredient in tobacco cigarettes, and the vapor is only inhaled so there's no secondhand smoke. Sales of e-cigarettes were anticipated to reach an estimated $1.7 billion last year, according to one study. That's as people opt for vaping as a way to stop smoking or to simulate smoking with less risk.
The FDA recently gave an advisory and that in warning about e-cigarettes. We know that probably the most harmful form of tobacco is still lighting a cigarette, because it's not only the danger of tobacco, but all the combustion products that are usually inhaled during combustion when you smoke a cigarette. So e-cigarettes may be safer, but I think it's going to take more research and data to be able to make that kind of a recommendation to the patients.
Dr. Lesmus says the Food and Drug Administration is directing more attention to e-cigarettes to learn more about their potential health risks, whether they truly help people stop smoking, and how the manufacturers are marketing vaping to young people who may end up being long-term customers. There's more to come after the break on Waterman Wellness. We'll visit the Connery Creation Health Kitchen to learn a recipe that's as healthy as a drink of water. A local surgeon will raise awareness about a common disease shared by hairdressers, waiters, and medical practitioners. And how do you stay active when your joints hurt? A local expert has helpful information for you. These stories and more are coming up in a few moments. But first, you may be interested in these upcoming events, classes, and seminars available to the community. Well, Welcome back to Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. I'm Michelle Wargo. Does the hot, humid Florida summer seem to slow you down? Weather-related pressure may actually trigger painful pressure in your joints. When you have arthritis, a disease which causes joint pain and affects people of all ages, the summer months can be debilitating.
As they become less and less active, of course, through sitting and riding, instead of walking, standing, the rest of their body gets in worse shape, not just the rest of the joints and their musculoskeletal system, but their cardiovascular system, everything starts to get worse. As they get more and more out of shape, they're doing less and less still, so it becomes a catch-22.
Dr. Radnathi says exercise is crucial if you have arthritis, but it can be hard to do and frustrating if joint pain is slowing you down. He recommends low-impact exercise to keep joints flexible and muscles strong. Some of these can be done inside and out of the heat. And you might consider stepping in the pool for a good summer workout. Swimming and walking in water are easy on the joints, and best of all, you'll stay cool in the Florida heat. Dr. Radnathi says if your joint pain has altered your life so you can't be active and do the things you want, it may be time for additional help from an orthopedist.
Just the pain control methods we use nowadays are phenomenal compared to what they were even 5 years ago. Now with our knee replacements, partial knee replacements, and we're able to quite often completely eliminate the pain, the post-op pain, those first 48 hours. Some of the different medications now, both injectable medications, oral medications, the machines, the self-medicating pain machines, we're able to keep that pain a heck of a lot better under control now than we did, like I said, 5-10 years ago.
Arthritis strikes 50 million adults and 300,000 children, which is why Dr. Radnathi says a healthy lifestyle combined with help from your doctor is important for conquering what is considered the leading cause of disability in the United States. We turn now to another condition that may potentially limit a person's activity, but surprisingly gets little attention. Vein disease, considered unsightly, can also be debilitating if left untreated. The condition, which appears as swollen, unsightly veins under the skin, is often hereditary, but can also develop from lifestyle activities.
Vein disease can be very sort of have a significant amount of morbidity to it, not only in the sense that it can affect people's lifestyles, affect their ability to stay active, exercise, or do so without pain, which they really shouldn't have to do if we have a treatable way of getting rid of that, or a way of treating that and getting rid of it. We do see more symptomatic disease in women, but it can occur in both men and women, and it occur in people of all ages. I always joke that vein disease is a disease of the hairdresser, the waiter, the nurse, and the doctor. So basically, anybody that stands on their feet for a long period of time puts excess stress on their veins, and therefore has a tendency to vein disease.
Symptoms associated with vein disease may include aching legs, usually after standing a lot. Your legs may feel heavy or are difficult to lift. Some experience an itching, burning sensation. The more progressed disease presents ulcers that don't heal and swollen ankles. Dr. Sebi says lifestyle changes can help ease symptoms, such as avoiding long periods of sitting or standing, propping up legs throughout the day, exercise, and wearing compression stockings. But for patients who are severely impacted by vein disease, Dr. Sebi says minimally invasive surgery using a laser is now available. The procedure, which can be done in the surgeon's office, takes less than an hour and offers immediate relief of symptoms with minimal scarring. And Dr. Sebi says it is typically covered by insurance. Did you know another important way to feel strong and stay active is to drink plenty of water? There are other potential sources of hydration, and they don't necessarily come in a glass. Let's visit the Connery Creation Health Center kitchen, where registered dietitian Stephanie Bassett and Florida Hospital Waterman executive chef Dave Atkinson will show us how to make a recipe that is cool for the summer and will hydrate you as well. It's the dog days of summer, so not only is it hot outside, but the last thing you want to do when you come home from work is stand in front of the stove and be hot inside as well. So here at Waterman Wellness, we have brought in our registered dietitian, Stephanie Bassett, and we also have our executive chef, Dave Atkinson, here to teach us a wonderful meal that requires no cooking. So what are we making today?
We're making a summer salad.
Oh, a summer salad, perfect. So what goes into this summer salad?
Well, I'm gonna start with the dressing, which is olive oil, Dijon mustard, honey, lemon juice, rice wine vinegar, and poppy seeds. And then we're gonna garnish the spinach with the sliced peaches. You can use any fruit, actually, peaches, plums, whatever you have available. Toasted almonds, the quinoa, and fresh raspberries.
All right, Chef Dave, we will leave you to it, and we'll discuss why this is such a great salad for summer.
This salad is great for a lot of different reasons. Primarily, it utilizes quinoa, which we don't see very commonly in cold options. Mm-hmm. Quinoa is a type of whole grain that's actually native to Peru and South America. It's fairly new for us here in the US, but it's really versatile. It can be used as a cold option, it can be used as a hot option. You can have it as a side dish, as a breakfast cereal, or it can be cold as a salad like we're using it today.
Now, what else makes this such a great salad to have, especially during the hot summer months?
The spinach. Spinach is a great source of fiber as well as lutein and zinc, which we don't get in a lot of different foods. And then peaches. Peaches are a really good source of vitamin C, and they add that nice sweetness to the salad. It gives it another dimension of flavor. And then the raspberries, of course, as well. Raspberries are a really wonderful source of fiber, and they're a really great source of antioxidants as well.
Wow, so we've got fiber, we've got protein, and we've got deliciousness. So why don't we get to tasting this salad?
Sounds great.
All right, it looks good, smells good. Let's see how it tastes.
Moment of truth.
Quinoa on a salad.
Mmm.
Yeah, it's an easy, delicious, nutritious summer salad. Thank you, Chef Dave, for joining us, and thank you, Stephanie.
Thank you.
And I will let you enjoy that salad.
Okay, sounds good.
Thank you for joining us as well. You'll find the complete summer salad recipe with step-by-step instructions on our website, watermanwellness.com. Want to introduce a wider variety of easy and healthy recipes to yourself and your family? Come check out the Yum Yum Club. The monthly classes held at the Connery Creation Health Center kitchen are open to the public. Participants make and sample several recipes at each two-hour session. At this recent class, students learned delicious ideas for breakfast for when you're on the go or hosting company. The next Yum Yum Club will be held on Tuesday, July 29th from 6 to 8 in the evening. The cost is $30 and each participant receives a recipe book, an apron, and other goodies. You can register by calling the number on your screen or visit ConneryCreationHealth.com. We hope you've enjoyed this month's Waterman Wellness, your pathway to healthy living with help from local experts. Be sure to watch for the August episode right here on Lake Sumter TV for some of the following stories. Just in time for back to school, a Lake County expert will offer tips for your children and yourself to stay well in school. We'll show you an exercise regime that may be just what the doctor ordered for people who need to ease into activity. And we'll go back to the Connery Creation Health Kitchen for a healthy snack everyone will enjoy. To learn more about the experts featured in this program, please visit watermanwellness.com. Until next time, I'm Michelle Wargo for Waterman Wellness.